Hi everyone, we are here for a little behind the scenes of the collaboration between James Bruton. I still don't know how to pronounce his surname, but I will learn very soon. The next step is to go and pick him up and his team to the airport. So I think that James and his team are in the air still, and we are already at the airport, so we have plenty of time. I think this one is James's flight, and the estimated arrival time is 20 minutes from now.
We are searching for James, and you can see there is a tourist.
Hello, James.
Hello.
Welcome.
How are you?
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
So,
let's fly rockets.
Yes, let's fly rockets. Yes.
We managed to bring James safely to the workshop.
Hello!
And this is the second part of the rocket challenge. So go and check James's channel. And now we are going to take a look at his rocket.
All right, let's have a look.
Here it is. This is my rocket, but let's take a look at James's.
All right, here it is.
Look at that. It looks great. Rockets, everyone. Rockets!
Rockets!
So James, I did put the engines on top of my rocket. Why did you put yours on the bottom?
So mostly because I thought that's what rockets should look like. So mine's a little bit different, where I've actually got an inertial measurement unit in my nose cone, which means as I tilt it, it should try and balance all of these EDFs, of which there are three, which is a bit of a weird configuration. So it's a bit like a drone, but with three. And hopefully these two overwhelm this one, and that one helps stabilise it that way, and these help balance it this way. So I've also got the ability to counteract for spin, because they all spin in the same direction. But I might have to tune it in software, depending on how it goes.
In case we have the chance.
If we go up and we don't know what's going to happen, it might crash or we might get several goes.
You are actively controlling the 3DFs, so if that I move it that way, this one breaks up, that one... That's scary.
Let's give it some throttle.
Cool.
Three, two, one.
Oh my god.
So both rockets are ready. You have seen the test that we did in the workshop, only catching it with our hands, so we don't know what's going to happen. Luckily, we have spares.
Oh, you've got a spare? Oh, can I paint that one blue?
So, and James does lots of great stuff too. Exoskeletons?
Yeah.
Giant Lego electric skateboard?
That's right.
Robot dogs?
Yeah, robot dogs.
Mini electric motorbikes?
Yeah, little red one.
Really printing stuff?
Yeah.
CNC?
Yeah. Well, I hope these light posts don't explode if we crash on them.
Yes, I will put padding on the bottom of my rocket just in case, because mine are on the bottom, but yours are on the top.
It's all right as long as we don't crash on the top. Yeah. But, you know, we can always...
Yes.
Use this tiny fire bucket.
The fire bucket or the fire extinguisher.
Yeah, that's suitable not for rockets.
Yes.
According to the box.
So, who's going first?
Rock, paper, scissors.
Let's go.
Okay.
One, two, three. You go first.
I win. Yes, the tape, good. Yes. Would you basically just hold
the cone?
Well, you yeah, there, plug sorry.
The battery.
Okay, we're all set.
fun and uncontrollable. That was my hover test, which didn't go very well. Right. Well, I think we've got glue. My battery did bite the dust, and I'm not that convinced about that. It's a funny shape.
Yes, I will not use that again. But we have spares.
Yeah, and we need to put the... Maybe you'd like to try yours now, and then I'll fix this.
I think so, yeah.
Before we try and you destroy anything else. I think I'm going to turn the gain down as well, because it's a bit... Hey, what am I doing?
I've seen that.
Oscillating, but that's the only way to test it, really.
Yeah.
Do you have super glue?
I will put a frame, taking into account that. Yes, this is going to go that way, this is going to go this way.
Yeah, like it looks
so
like...
I should.
Yeah?
Yeah. I thought it was going to just go up, and I didn't want to just stop it.
Yes,
it has broken,
wait there, because no, don't move it. I will put lots of tape there.
We did a very bad test, and we are trying to really try and fixing it with a very rudimentary technique of bracing it with tape, which is not meant for this, but I'm used to fails, so we are going to make it work.
Don't use all the tape, because we might need more. I suspect we will.
Full beans.
Yeah.
Take two.
Okay.
Let's go.
Not that bad. pretty good top speed.
Well, then
I've seen pretty good top speed.
Maybe I needed a little bit.
Why did it go up so much in the workshop?
I don't know. But I think it was a really good test. You know, direction, half and half, horizontal. But full speed, it was really quick. Look, the pieces, they went really far. Right?
Did they go further than mine? Who's winning
yes.
so far? I travelled further.
No, I think yours went far.
Right, let's have a look then. Battery came out, so at least you haven't. One of them came out.
But I think I can still. You mind, James? I'm not done. It is still works. You mind?
Okay.
No crawling zero. No crawling. Rocket
electric
crawling.
Electric snake.
Electric snake. Maybe a two?
Did you bring the spare rocket?
Yes, but I don't think we have the rest of the parts.
Okay.
Some of it. Yeah, this is what killed my rocket.
A flying stone hit it.
Yes. The entire Earth moved up. How do you say when the people organize against you?
Conspiracy. Like,
yes. There is a universe conspiracy, and they moved the entire Earth towards my rocket, and that's why it failed. That has to be it.
So I'm trying to fix my rocket, and we're gonna have another go, and I'm gonna turn the gain down a bit, then we're just gonna go for it and see how high it goes, and then hope it doesn't turn upside down again.
Well, I'm trying to convert my rocket from three engines and six control surfaces to a single rocket, no control surfaces. This is going to be like a missile, no rocket anymore. Can we swap the title of the thing? Instead of rocket challenge, missile challenge?
Well,
I already have the
horizontal
speed.
It?
I only need to aim. You will be amazed about how much stuff I can remove from my rocket and still go partially up. I'm going for having something to launch. I'm really afraid that the motor is not going to be powerful enough to lift it from the ground. But
horizontal speed is going to be great.
Oh, there.
Yes, and this is all that we are going to be using because we only need one motor and it is going to start freaking out and spinning, but hopefully it will do that while going up.
What's that nasty sound?
Did they stop?
Level, hold it, level!
Sorry. I was looking at the cap. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm just going to unplug the battery.
Yes?
I've lost the rotor. Oh, I've lost a fin and a rotor, and these are really sharp. I don't know why it came off. The collet's come off the motor. It must have happened when it crashed.
There's nothing to see here. Move along. It's not the droid you're looking for.
I'm just reprogramming some stuff. I'm just changing the gain because it's a bit like an oscillator at the moment. How much do we have? It's on 15, let's have 10. It's a bit of a wobbly rocket now because of all the tape and the holes in it, but it'll probably be the same as last time.
It doesn't sound like right.
Whoa, your EDF is loose and the wires are getting pulled.
Oh, I see copper.
Yeah,
that might be.
Okay. That will short out the motor driver, which will go bang immediately.
I'm not sure at all that this is going to work, but we will try. And now rocket challenge part 2.
Now the cows have gone.
Full thrust, no tests. Perfect. A land submarine. Okay, James, all our vertical hopes are on you. I cover the horizontal, vertical is on you.
Vertical!
Well, it's rocket challenge number 2, the duct tape express into space!
One of my EDFs exploded, the other one's broken.
At this time because the servo is broken. These are rubbish. Plastic EDFs. The collars don't grip the motors properly. Can try again.
Yes.
Well, it'd be even harder with actual rockets, with actual fire, wouldn't it?
Yes.
Because how would you even... I suppose you'd have to have flaps, but... It's a shame yours didn't go up because I really thought that was going to...
Yeah, I thought... That
at least do some, at least stay upright and like stay the right way up, and then yeah. Sort of it should have hovered really. I don't know, even if landing was hard.
All good?
Yep. One EDF was broken and it was loose, and I tried to tape it in position, but obviously it wasn't quite right and it's made it spin, and maybe one of the wires came out at some point, so we lost an EDF and it just caused it to go crazy. First test was better.
It was a great test. It got up, then it went my style, horizontal.
Yeah.
And then
it
missile
went down, actually went into the ground.
Yeah, missile style.
And that's this time probably
it,
okay.
Yeah, it didn't
hit rocks this time.
Yes.
That's a present for you. Thank you
for
hosting the event.
Thank you.
So how good of a YouTuber is James that both rockets are fine on his channel and on mine they are both destroyed? But we had a very good fun and thanks a lot for coming visiting me
Thank
and
you.
Helping me with this project, James. And go and check James's channel, it is full of great stuff. And that's it for this week. Thanks a lot for everything, liking, sharing, commenting on my videos. Thanks a lot for your Patreon support to the both of us. Please check the links in the description if you want to support us. If you are still not subscribed, please go and subscribe to James's and my channel. And now please go
and make something.
Have you seen the poop cloud?